Listening Library presents It Wasn't Me by Dana Alison Levy. Read for you by Robbie Daymond, Ramón de Ocampo, Emily Wu Zeller, Jorjeana Marie, Adenrele Ojo, J.B. Adkins, and Kaz Harleaux.
With a note read by the author.
This book is dedicated to the teachers and educators who do the hard work of helping our kids find their way, and especially to the ones in my family, Steve, Mary, Tracy, Pat, Paul, Peggy, Erica, and Jen, Ms. Lewiston's all.
Chapter 1. Day 1 Assessments.
Shipton Middle School. Please fill out the following questions as honestly and completely as you can. There are no wrong answers. Date, February 18th. Name.
Molly Claremont.
What happened and what were you thinking at the time of the incident?
I have literally no idea. I was waiting to be picked up and I wandered into the student gallery, which isn't a crime last I checked. And the photos were totally ruined, which was really surprising and, you know, upsetting. Because, of course, our school is no place for vandalism and bullying. But I just walked in there. And the next day, when someone opened the darkroom door and ruined Theo's stuff again, that was horrible. And I feel so bad for him. Our community definitely needs to come together and make this a bully-free zone. I should bring it up with student council. Maybe we can do a bake sale for Theo. Anyway, I realize I don't have an alibi. But why would I touch his stuff? I can't see how it has anything to do with me.
What have you thought about since?
Well, to be totally honest, because we're supposed to be honest here, right? I'm mostly thinking how ridiculous it is that I'm being blamed for ruining Theo's photos. I'm sure it feels terrible for him, having his work destroyed like that, with people writing such horrible, embarrassing stuff. The whole school can't stop talking about it. But still, it's not my fault.
What about this has been hardest for you?
Again, if I'm being honest, I cannot believe I have to spend an entire week here in this detention room, or justice circle room or whatever. I get that this is a big deal, but it wasn't me.
What do you think needs to be done to make things as right as possible?
We'll obviously need to establish a better Say No to Bullying campaign. I'll definitely be bringing it up with the student council. We don't want vandals and criminals in the school. But it has nothing to do with me. Nothing.
Is there anything at all you'd like to share confidentially with Ms. Lewiston?
No.
Name.
Andre Hall.
What happened and what were you thinking at the time of the incident?
I dropped my bag off in the student gallery and went to the bathroom before going home. I didn't want to bring my bag in with me because that bathroom floor is nasty. So I left my bag, then on my way back, realized I had forgotten my lab notebook. It was 15 minutes before I got back to the gallery, and by then, Theo's photos were totally ruined. Whoever it was, they weren't playing. It was bad. But like I keep saying, I wasn't even there. When I walked back to get my bag, there were a ton of people in the gallery, all freaking out.
What have you thought about since?
It was pretty intense. I've never seen anything like it at our school before. I mean, that was some severe destruction and some rude stuff written on the photos of Theo. I'd want to transfer schools if that happened to me. And then the very next day, someone messed with his stuff in the darkroom? It seems like someone's got it in for him. But I don't know. Does he have enemies or something? I barely know the guy. It's not like he talks to me. And like I keep saying, I wasn't even there until after.
What about this has been hardest for you?
It's a bummer that no one even noticed that I wasn't there, and that it was only my bag sitting on the bench. Though maybe whoever did it figured it would be better to have more suspects or something. I was planning on spending vacation week practicing a ton with my band, and now I'm stuck here. And since my bandmates go to a different school, it's hard to get rehearsal time. We have some big stuff coming up, and we were counting on this week. But it's obviously worse for Theo. I mean, he must be freaking out. I know I would be.
What do you think needs to be done to make things as right as possible?
I guess catch the guy who did it and make him apologize? Not really sure, since I didn't have anything to do with it.
Is there anything at all you'd like to share confidentially with Ms. Lewiston?
Just, how could nobody notice that I wasn't there?
Name.
Eric Estrella.
What happened and what were you thinking at the time of the incident?
I don't really remember. I had a huge game against Greenfield that night, and I was mostly thinking about whether I'd be starting point guard. I was. I scored 19 points. It was a totally sick game. Coach gave me the golden jockstrap.
What have you thought about since?
I don't know. I didn't do it, so I just want to get out of here.
What about this has been hardest for you?
I was supposed to do a full-day basketball camp this week with a whole team, and Coach was seriously mad when he heard I can't make it. He said I shouldn't expect to start if I get in trouble at school.
What do you think needs to be done to make things as right as possible?
I don't know. I mean, I figure Theo must have made someone really mad. Like, is he in a fight with anyone? I feel really sorry for the guy, but I don't know what to do for him.
Is there anything at all you'd like to share confidentially with Ms. Lewiston?
What happens if no one confesses at the end of this whole thing? Will it all go away?
Name.
Alice Shu.
What happened and what were you thinking at the time of the incident?
Actually, I remember exactly what I was thinking. Because I was trying to figure out if it would be possible to do a knife wound on a zombie, or if, since there's no blood, there's not much point. This is special effects for my movies, obvs. Anyway, I had been pondering this, and I walked into the wall by the water fountain near the student gallery and smacked my shoulder hard enough to drop my books. By the time I picked everything up, I had missed the bus. I had to wait for a ride, and I knew it would be a while, so I decided to walk over to the gallery. When I got there, Molly Claremont was freaking out. I've never seen anyone turn that color red. Maybe she had never read any of those words before. They were pretty bad. Poor Theo. Then the very next day, his stuff was ruined again in the dark room. Someone must be out to get him. Maybe there's a secret stalker. Maybe that person is in this room right now.
What have you thought about since?
Zombies look dumb with knives sticking out of them. Without blood, or at least a festering wound, there's really nothing happening. And since they're undead, it just sticks out, looking stupid. Oh, you mean Theo's photos? Well, I guess someone really hates him. Or the idea of him. A lot of people say they can't stand me, but they don't even know me. They just assume.
What about this has been hardest for you?
I don't really care. I didn't have plans this week, other than working on some special effects. But I can do them after detention, or justice circle, or whatever we're calling this.
What do you think needs to be done to make things as right as possible?
Well, it'd be great if there was a huge zombie revenge scene, where Theo is commanding the undead to get back at whoever trashed his stuff. But in real life, there's not much we can do when jerks mess with us. I'm sure Theo's really embarrassed, but he shouldn't worry. It will all die down and people will forget about it. I would know.
Is there anything at all you'd like to share confidentially with Ms. Lewiston?
Do you really think people will tell the truth here?
Name.
Jax Fletcher.
What happened and what were you thinking at the time of the incident?
Nothing. I don't remember anything about that day. It was another school day.
What have you thought about since?
No one knows who did it. So I don't really know why we have to be here. Without proof, isn't this against the law or something? My parents okayed it because they're always down for some new age, talk it out and everyone will feel better stuff. But give me a break.
What about this has been hardest for you?
I'll probably get in more trouble for saying this, but I hate school. And now I have to spend vacation week here.
What do you think needs to be done to make things as right as possible?
Theo needs to get over it. There's no point in this.
Is there anything at all you'd like to share confidentially with Ms. Lewiston?
What do we have to do to get...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.